Hello everyone. Today I will tell you the details of treatment in atopic dermatitis. It is divided into two parts, non-pharmacological treatment and pharmacological treatment. In non-pharmacological treatment, we have to apply some moisturizers, and in pharmacological treatment, topical steroids, topical calcineurin inhibitors, and also there is a role of PDE4 inhibitors.
So in the topical moisturizer, emollients and the occlusive agents can be applied. So in emollients, glyceryl can be used, and in occlusive agents, petrolatum can be used. It will prevent the pruritus, fissuring and lichenification. Even the role of the bleach bath, in this we can give the bath by the diluent sodium hypochlorite. It is very effective. Now in the pharmacological treatment, it is the main treatment in which anti-inflammatory medications, corticosteroids, calcineurin inhibitors and PDE4 inhibitors are used. And treatment should be severity based. Not all the topical agents will be used at a one time. First, we have to give the topical steroid very low potency. If patient will respond, then need not to be go step up. But if patient will not respond, then moderate potent steroid topically will be applied. And if still the patient is not responding and becoming chronic, then only we will use the calcineurin inhibitors or PDE4 inhibitors. I will tell you the details of all these. So first, in topical corticosteroids, we should prefer the low potency tube hydrocortisone butyrate 0.1%, and it should be applied locally. And also we should advise the patient that we should taper it slowly. Example, if I am starting the tube hydrocortisone regime for the patient according to the severity, for first 5 days we can apply twice or thrice, then for next 5 days slowly I will decrease either single or twice application. Then for next 5 days alternate day, and then slowly patient should stop applying this tube. Or we can use the tube fluticasone propionate 0.05%. And there are some side effects of the topical steroids. Skin atrophy can occur, telangiectasia, strike and develop. And if it is not available and patient is not responding to these low potency steroid, then mometasone can also be used. Now the role of the topical calcineurin inhibitors, these are effective as a steroid sparing agent. There is no side effect of the steroid, so we can use for the chronic atopic dermatitis. Sometime patient is having the symptoms for a long time, patient is not responding to the steroid or developing the side effects of the topical steroid. In this case, we can use the topical calcineurin inhibitors, in which topical tacrolimus 0.03% for the more than 2 years age children only, and also for more than 16 years age group 0.1% ointment can be used. So concentration 0.03% for more than 2 years and 0.1% for more than 16 years, but it should not be used in less than 2 years age group. And another calcineurin inhibitors topically available is pimecrolimus. And side effects of topical calcineurin inhibitors are child may having some itching, irritation, burning sensation because of this medication. Now another is a PDE4 inhibitor. It is phosphodiesterase 4 inhibitor. It is also not used in the less than 2 years age group. So these two medicines we cannot use in the atopic dermatitis of infancy. So in atopic dermatitis of infancy, only emollients and the topical steroid can be used. If patient will develop the chronic atopic dermatitis or symptoms after the 2 years of age, and in this case we can try these two drugs, calcineurin inhibitors and PDE4 inhibitors. If patient is not responding to all these topical regime, then we can give the oral treatment in the form of immunosuppressant or oral corticosteroids. So in oral immunosuppressant, we can give the cyclosporine 3 to 6 mg per kg per day, or we can use the azathioprine, or we can use the mycophenolate or methotrexate. So dose of azathioprine is 2.5 to 4 mg per kg per day, mycophenolate 0.6 to 1.2 gram per meter square, and methotrexate 0.2 to 0.7 milligram per kilogram per week. Or we can use the systemic corticosteroid oral prednisolone 1 to 2 mg per kg per day, then in taper dose, or we can use the methyl prednisolone. But we have to use oral medication only in later stage when patient is not responding to the topical treatment. So main treatment of the atopic dermatitis is topical emollients and the topical steroids. Other treatment we use in a chronic case or having the more severe manifestation. So in this stepwise approach, first step will be topical moisturizer and low potency topical steroid. If patient is not responding, we have to go step up, in which with emollients we will give the moderate potent topical steroid. If not responding, then highly potent topical steroid. If still patient is not responding and age is less than 2 years, then we can give the oral steroids. If age is more than 2 years, then with the topical steroid we can add the topical PDE4 inhibitors or calcineurin inhibitors. If patient is not responding even to these two topical agents, then only we will try the oral systemic immunosuppressant and corticosteroids. We should also advise the relatives to avoid the allergens, and also if there is superadded skin infection, we should treat it. So this is the all about the treatment of atopic dermatitis. Thank you so much.